over here. Mr. John Fugelsang, one of my favorite comedians who will be at the Maskers Cabaret in West Hollywood March 21st and 28th. Give a hand.
We are, we're on a new terrain here.
We're live and new. And new and live.
We're new and live. Live and new. Unless you're listening to this on demand or a pre-record.
Then we're not live.
Then we're not live.
But it was done
live. It was done live, though, so you know that.
It was live as fuck. That's what the kids are saying. We're in a new studio.
We're in a new studio.
My first question is, to you, did those bastards at Entertainment Weekly win the war?
Number one, I think they won the war.
They took our house.
And let me tell you, what they did to us.
What did they do to us?
They got us.
Yeah.
Like the first round of Jews in the Holocaust, they just tricked into saying, we got to move you a little bit. Because what they did to us was, I was told, we're going to Studio 5. We're at Studio 12.
By who, Studio
who
12.
Wants it? It's stupid anyway.
Yeah, Studio Ben 12. And Debbie aren't even there on Mondays anymore.
They're not there. There's nothing to look at. We're just getting blaring light coming in from those blinds.
And from the beginning, we knew it was Opie's broom closet.
It was always Opie's footlocker. Absolutely. And we didn't want to be part of that. So what were... They said we're getting Studio 5. And they go,
Studio 5. Great number.
We are... This is the big thing. It was, well, we're the show of Studio 5. Like, this is the show that's being... That's going to be here.
Feels good.
There's going to be some... Well, yeah. They schedule other people to kind of come in. It'll be used during the day and stuff, obviously. Look, I'm not thinking they built us a fucking studio. I'm not crazy.
Yeah.
But, you know, other people are going to use it. But this, it's the Bonfires studio. It's that thing.
So cool. We have top position.
I started feeling there was tinges of bullshit in that. When we're like, can we hang the show enough picture? Can we, the crackle crackle? Do we have to, does it have to be dragged up and down the stairs by Jacob every day?
Gifts from fans and friends?
Can we make this studio art? They go, oh, well, the new comedy office is pretty great.
Which I will say it is.
It looks
great.
It's going to look pretty great up there, but that's not where we do our thing generally.
No, that's the, you know what that is? Is that's the guest room, and this is supposed to be the living room.
Then.
Okay. Now I'm starting to go 0-60.
Oh, yeah. Buddy,
is the engine
start
on?
Ramping up.
Is the engine off?
The back wheel should be spinning already.
I don't know why I'm a lawnmower.
Lou goes, Lou, we're downstairs smoking a cigarette. Lou goes, I'm going upstairs.
Yeah.
I'll let you know. I'll text you, let you know if the studio's open. You can go in the studio.
Excuse
he
me?
Goes, so he goes, I'll text you, let you know if it's open. I come up. I didn't look at my phone yet. Me and Christine walk over here. I look in the window and I see the door. I don't want to interrupt anybody doing something. All I see is where you're sitting, John Fugelsang.
Okay.
Now, I go, oh, there must be a show, something's still going on. I start walking away. I grab my phone, then when I see Lou says, Studio 5's open.
Okay.
So I go, all right, that's weird. So I come back and I walk in. John Fugelsang goes, hey, he goes, sorry, I'm going to get out of here in a second. I'm like, oh, yeah, no worries, whatever you got to do. Lou's in here. He then proceeds to give me a breakdown of what clearly is John Fugelsang's fucking studio, as we're looking again at backdrop for another goddamn thing. You didn't even pay attention to when you walked in.
Oh, no, because I just assumed it said Bonfire.
He walked me through this place like MTV fucking Cribs. And that is absolutely... Lou, am I right?
Fugelsang did?
Fugelsang walked me. He goes, hey, you know, I go,
school. This right here, this is my sneaker closet. This is where I keep all the Jordans.
And this is where the magic happens, dog.
This is my bedroom.
He might as well have. He gave me a walkthrough of all the... He goes, oh, man. He goes, the computers come out of the thing. It's all the bells and whistles once you get on. He goes, "That's I brought in this power strip. He goes, and I just put that in there. He goes, but you guys can use it. He goes, I think you'll find it very helpful points. We asked Sirius for a recycling bin for this studio because, you know, we waste a lot of paper. 20 minutes later, it was here. He says, give me the rundown.
So
this place is so great. He's explaining to me the lighting of this place.
It's like when you have a really big crush on a girl, and she's like, hey, do you want to get lunch? And you're like, yeah, this is all coming together. And then you go meet up with lunch, and her boyfriend's sitting with her. And she's like, this is my boyfriend, Mike, that I told you about. And you're like, hey, Mike. And you're like, let me tell you something about her. She's the best. She always remembers to call me when I'm down. And you're like, ha-ha. Oh, you guys seem so happy together.
He goes,
he goes,
he uses the royal we, not including me, actually.
The royal we.
Yeah. We, his show, he said.
And by the way, that's infuriating. The cop
light. I hate it. He goes, we're getting some tension rod things custom made to fit these windows so we can blank out these windows, too. We're doing that. Now, he didn't say, we're going to talk to everybody who's in the studio here. We're going to talk to the Bonfire people, since this is Bonfire Studio, so that's, I was smoke blowing up my ass.
Yeah, that was the suppository they gave us.
They're going to get some custom blinds for that. But he goes, don't worry. He goes, but you can do whatever you want, because they're custom made. They can open and close. You can do whatever you want.
It'd be funny if he started putting restrictions on it real quick. Also, real big thing here. Don't like the F word said in the studio. I'm just going to kind of say it's going to mess up the vibe. Again, we're in the insight. We're looking to solve problems, so no nudity, no F words.
He was super sweet.
Oh, John Fugelsang's one of the nicest guys ever.
But we were absolutely found out in that moment that we are in the Sirius XM Insight.
You went to dinner with your girl, with your crush's boyfriend, and Jacob lied to us and said she was single. You lied to us and said she was single.
Lie.
You looked at us right in the face.
You said this was going to be the Bonfire Studio. So not only did Entertainment Weekly...
So like the Jews in Poland, you just got us to move on our own volition. We put ourselves in the gas chambers.
How do you feel, Jacob?
I'm walking in with you.
Say what you are. You wanted us dead. You walked us into a trap.
Look
at Jacob's like, Oz, you should definitely go over
to
the
studio. You know we can't put Shownuff up in here and John Fugelsang's studio?
He can't put anything up in here.
He's got
have fucking banners, too. I'll have our banners here. I didn't know.
I want our banners in there, and I want his banners broken in the hallway.
You got it.
I want him hung up as just proof that he can't enter these at certain times.
Put them on sticks.
You know, like in Gangs of New York, where they put the rabbit out? That's what I want. I want this to know that there's a war going on.
So I just want you to know, because I'm pretty sure you had no. I didn't know until
I'll tell you this,
minutes before the show. This is not our studio.
Thank you for telling me.
We were in EW studio, and now we are on Sirius XM Insight studio.
Because when I walked in, I was like, hey. That was kind of that. I tried to give you that look of like, hey, new studio.
I wasn't having it.
At all. I thought you were mad at me.
No, and I couldn't watch you. I couldn't watch you just feel good about it for too long. I was like, shush, I don't want to talk about it yet.
Yeah, I felt that like you were like, don't come. It's like in Heat.
It's
like where she waves off Val Kilmer. She's like,
really? He's just walking by a friend though doing that. Like, it's like, we're at war. I'll tell you more in a second.
Yeah.
And you're like, wait, what? Don't walk away. And I goes, we're at war. I'm going to go grab a Diet Coke. What?
Yeah, I'm going to go grab pretzel sticks. We're at war.
We're at war. I'm going to grab a coffee.
Yeah. Are you thirsty or anything? All right, I'll see you in 5 minutes.
We're at war.
But also, we're at war. But don't forget, we are at war.
Just, you know, I just want you to know where we're at war.
Okay. Do you even know how much money I have authorized for beefed up security in this place? Because every person who walks in here tonight is going to pass through a metal detector.
They were shooting at me.
Can we let the cops figure out who they were and we're not shooting at, please?
I never went on Fugelsang's side.
Huh? Wait, so what I'm did Fugelsang said? Side. What did Fugelsang say?
He called me a fat bitch. And and what? Fucking Dan just like...
From where?
Dan, he goes, you're cool. And Dan's like, oh, he thinks I'm cool. Yeah. He fell for his handsome charms.
I did. I fell for
it. Fugelsang host? What was he host of?
The John Fugelsang fucking third string comedy hour.
I mean, we got, yeah, it's we discussed it in depth on our third.
No, it's Fugelsang is a political show.
Political.
Oh, really? I thought he was like a game show host.
He has that, yes.
When I used
that energy's there.
Yeah, I thought I knew him from a game show hosting.
He may have hosted a game show.
Now, in that show, do you think Fat Bitches could have won?
No, probably
maybe
not.
Maybe it stems from that.
No, he's probably always been very against...
He called you a fat bitch to your face?
Basically.
That's not true at all. He's going off an energy that he feels.
Might as well have.
Did he not even say fat bitch?
No.
What did he say?
He goes, hey, sorry, I'll clean up the studio. I don't want to get into it.
Is he here before you?
Yeah.
Oh, that motherfucker.
But I don't want to get into it too much because we cover it in depth on Thursday.
Oh.
You no, Ari.
Yes.
I complained.
To whom?
Here. To the world.
About,
America.
About?
America and I believe parts of Canada.
UK?
I complained. That's something I think some of the UK gets.
Really?
Wherever satellite signals are hacked. I came and kind of complained that, like, one, it wasn't even so, the mess was the least of my issues.
You left a mess here.
Not really. It's sometimes they don't, but sometimes, right, Lou? Sometimes they do.
Yeah. A lot of times we've got to clean up after them.
That wasn't even my complaint. My complaint was we're doing the lost tapes pre-record every day now. Yeah. And we have from 5 to 6 to do that. And then this show starts. And we'd like to, you know, take a break for 8 seconds before we start the live show.
Yeah.
So we got to start as close to 5 as possible. come 506, 507, 508.
You still in here?
I think they're still in here sometimes. And then when we
come in too, you're like, oh, hey.
We poke in, there's the awkward hey. And then it seems like a very casual, come on, anyone in this fucking room back me up? Everyone's staring at me like, Jay's like a little whiny girl about this.
Wait, I don't know. What happened?
Our show is just as important as his show. He needs to get the fuck out.
At 5 o'clock, he goes, hey, guys, even if he doesn't know, it's like, guys, like if I'm hosting this show and someone else comes in, I'm like, guys, we got to go to another show. Let's talk in the hallway. Right.
I feel like everyone...
Yes. That's why Jay feels...
Now, I'm not saying that that's not sort of happening. But that happening, this guy's going to talk in the hallway. It's like, oh, yeah, okay. He goes, so, Jacob, so we'll talk about that thing tomorrow. Like, not moving yet, and then it's like, everything just seems very casual. It's a very casual exit. When it's like, you know, okay, man, we got to get this thing started here.
Do you ever try to passive him?
Huh?
Do you ever try to passive aggressive him? Which where you just like,
yeah, sigh.
No, not even that. Just like start and be like, hey, so we're on.
I do this.
Bonfire.
Sometimes I do it where I walk in and like, oh, shit, you guys are still in here. Sorry.
Oh, yeah.
Like, oh, look at the clock.
Yeah. Oh, shit, is this, it's still you? Oh, no, all right, we're okay, we'll be out in the hall.
That's great.
We'll be out in the hall just waiting.
By the way, that's a perfect impression how both of us handle it every time. You walk in, you go, oh, hey, you guys, yeah, oh, what?
Oh, shit, did we walk in here early?
Oh, 5:10, yeah. Okay.
Okay, all right.
We'll be out here. No, we'll be out in the hallway. Finish up.
Yeah, Dan was right in the pocket with me until the guy goes, saw you on a billboard in L.A., and then Dan's like...
By the way...
Who was just talking right there?
He dropped to his knees.
But for, I didn't even know who... Was that...
By the way...
Oh, that was Jay. It was an impression?
Yeah.
Wow, I could not tell.
It wasn't me, sucking John.
Down for a second.
It wasn't me sucking John.
Watch, close your eyes. Which one of us is this?
No, I know. That's for sure soda.
No, that's me, dude. It was me again.
Oh, that was... Yeah.
I don't know. My eyes were still closed. It stopped.
You know me. I'll blow a liberal radio host at the drop of the guy.
So, we were both all wound up about this. And now Jacob went and said something.
Is that true, Jacob?
To Don Wicklund. Yeah. Don Wicklund.
Oh, the head?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Big Don? Big Don Wicklund?
Yes.
Cowboy
He comes down, deals with it somehow. He says something to John Fugelsang. And when we come in today, I come in sort of like head, just like eyes down, doing in my phone, right? Just trying to like, all right, you guys. Because they were like, oh, yeah, come on in. And it was
I know we'll come in because it's our studio now.
I did not give off that vibe. We went in. I stepped off immediately to the left to let them kind of clear out. And they came over and they were like, we'll do everything we can to not leave our pigsty behind here for you.
Because Wick told them.
Yeah.
And then when he said pig, he made eye contact with Jay.
Yeah, he goes, pig,
sty. Wow.
He goes like this, he goes,
and then,
we'll do everything we can. Instead of saying what they should have done, if I did this, I'd be like, hey, sorry about the mess. That's fucking shitty of me. I won't do it anymore. I apologize.
And as while he
we'll
was,
do we can,
and while he was cutting, while he was cutting an apple with a switchblade knife, he said to me with his eyes down, he goes, you guys, what are you guys, every day now? And we were like, you know, no, it's 3 a week. We're doing Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. He goes, I thought you guys were going every day now. And then Fuel sounds like, oh, no, that's not every day yet, huh? Yeah. And then walked out. And then as he was walking out, he runs to Dan. And he goes, Dan, oh, my God, I saw you on a billboard in L.A. And Dan was like, thanks, man. He didn't even say it was a good billboard. He didn't say he was happy to see him on a billboard. Just informed him that it existed. And Dan was already fucking... Dan just goes, yes, 1,000 times yes. He's like, I didn't ask you anything.
Yeah, I go, well, if you saw me, then everybody must have saw me. You smell so good. And then he's like, what? And he goes, whatever. I was just talking to your
Dan was like,
dumb roommate.
You want to buy sweaters this weekend? I don't care.
I go, hey, I just want to let you know I've been listening to your show and I think everything you say is right. I'm a really big fan of you.
Wow. And, wow.
And right, he goes, I saw you on a billboard. I go, did you see? You did? Oh, that's crazy. Did you? Oh, that's awesome. Oh, what? Dude, thanks for hanging around and telling me.
Earns credibility. Says that to a nozillions is not a... Oh, ready?
Wow.
Earns credibility as billions actor who knows. Is this Sarah McPants?
How are you already making fucking things about it?
Oh, this is quick. Our people are quick. Anyways, it's on the Thursday show, which you can hear about more of the beef on the Lost Tapes on Thursday.
I'd like to start hearing John Fugelsang's show. What can I hear about that? Taught political humor.
Yeah, it's on the channel. I don't know.
Yeah, you know exactly what channel. You know what time it's on, too.
I go, what? My phone's all full with bootleg versions.
You're straight up goes,
used to host America's Funniest Home Videos with Daisy Fuentes.
I knew it was something. I knew it was something.
That's exactly. I didn't even realize
you went from that.
You
know politics?
What? Oh, man, I'm a bigger fan now because I know he's got a funny side and he probably does cool voices during the video.
You think his hand still smells like Daisy Fuentes?
Dude, you stop
he
it.
He took over from Uncle Jesse? Or not Uncle Jesse. Bob Saget. No. America's Funniest Home Videos.
Was that
what's the other one? What's the other one?
Funniest Home Videos.
America's Funniest
People. That was Dave Coulier.
That's Dave Coulier. I mean, he took over that from Saget.
Yeah, he got that Saget money.
Damn.
That's
no, he wasn't there. I think Saget may have even been after him.
Jay. No, I thought it was Saget's show.
Jay. He goes, you're alone with him in here, and he's fucking peeling another apple with a knife, and he goes, you know what you remind me of, Jay? One of those fat kids that falls into the pool on America's Funniest Home Videos. There you go. What? He goes,
you know what? Catch you tomorrow. Oh, guess not. You're only 3 days a week. Pink belly.
Yeah.
Pink belly. You're going to walk out of the room.
Stay safe.
Do you want to know the cool part about those videos? You know what we don't show?
I'm dying at the end.
All right. Take it easy. Dan saw you on the billboard. I go, can I kiss you? Can I kiss you in the mouth?
Pink belly.
Oh, look how young and unoffensive the Jay he looks there.
That's how he looks like. He looks like fucking Dan Soder. That's what Dan loves.
Maybe that's why he likes me.
Dan sees himself in there.
The hoodie.
Hey, want to go hoodies t-shirt. And t-shirting this weekend?
Dude, I love hoodies and t-shirts.
Is there a logo on that t-shirt?
No.
Oh, yeah, then I'm in.
Perfect. Can I wear it anywhere at any time?
For sure you can.
Done and done. Is it more of a, would you call it a forest green with a black hoodie? I'm in!
He's doing the talk show host thing where they don't know what to do with their hands, so they're just putting it in front of them.
That's what I do.
We have a great show today.
I want to hear his work.
Yeah.
Walk downstairs.
You think he fucked Daisy Fuentes?
No.
You don't
no
think he ever
way
fucked her?
She was married.
If he did,
yeah,
I'll be his bitch.
God, I hope he did.
Fugle Sang, call in now and let us smell your finger.
If we can get any Fugle Sang that he fucked Daisy Fuentes, that he actually did it.
I didn't know he was.
Confirmation. I happen to know Daisy Fuentes, big gamber.
Big Gabber?
Yeah.
No, Big Camper. She's really a big fan of our show.
Oh, Big Camper.
What's she up to?
Huh? Videos, the show that turns
probably 48, 49.
Yeah.
Thank you
know
very much for
big
tuning
cans
in.
Big
cans. Oh, she was
very
hot.
Very special night.
You mean tonight when we're taping this or tonight when we actually air?
You're crazy.
When is this airing?
I have no idea.
Oh.
Never mind. Forget I said anything. Folks, you're here on a really tonight. Thank you.
She goes, oh, so they're fighting like they've been dating for 20 years. She goes, all right, you fucking asshole. He goes, yeah, I saw you on a billboard.
Did you just come in a fight?
Yeah. He goes, before we walk out there and watch these hilarious videos, I'm going to fucking hit you.
Cunt. I've got you, cunt. I've got you, cunt.
I mean, then it just goes to great videos. You can't really be mad.
Ooh, that's sexy.
Oh, yeah. Coming back with gas on the fire. It's the bonfire. Comedy Central Radio.
Comedy Central Radio.
Sirius XM 95. I'm just laying around in a silk robe. I'm Dan Soder. And with me as always, my army tag team partner in this devil's threesome, Big J. Okazan.
Now I'm gonna need you to lay back and let me and Daddy Dan swallow you up.
Get ready for heat and warmth.
I'm giving back shots like blow,
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 blow.
Don't touch me.
Make me something neat. Get the fuck out this house. My main bitch coming home in like 15 minutes.
You gotta understand something, baby. You can't take all my time. Pack a lunch, baby.
Cause I'm gonna be eating out that snappy nappy dugout. 55 minutes.
You better put on a hard hat.
Cause
I'll tell you what. Go to work. On you.
This put me in a good mood. I came in.
The sensual bonfire tapes.
I came in, that's right, it's the bonfire lost tapes, and I came in hot.
Angry.
Hot today, and I'm happy Jacob's here. I'm not angry at Jacob at all, but I literally want something done about this.
What happened?
I hate to be this guy.
Okay. We're 4 days like a week. You can be a little bit more of a diva.
I'd like to do the show when we can. By the way, I can fuck this up often, as anybody can be a little late or whatever. I know we're all rushing to get here, to be here on time to do the show. If we can, from the hour that we say we're going to do it, they say we can come in the studio at 5 o'clock. And if we could go somewhere like 5:05 to 5:35, gives us a little more of a break before we start the live show.
Yeah.
And 5:05, 5:06, every time we come here, Fuglesang and his merry band of whoever the fucks are in here, and they always, I've always gotten the goddamn vibe from the people in that show, that they're like, oh, hey, kiddo, yeah, we'll get out of your hair. Don't worry, you know. Yeah. You don't get that from them?
I get the vibe of when you're at, have you ever been, this is such a meathead thing to say, but have you ever been at the gym and someone's using equipment and you ask to use their equipment and there's like a weird vibe where they're angry at you but you don't know why? Where you're like, hey, man, can I jump in? And they're like, yeah, I got two more sets. You're like, I just wanted to work out too. We're both here at this place. That's kind of the vibe I get, where they're always like, oh, you guys want to use it now? All right, yeah, well, I mean, I guess I'm just going to change my life for you. And you're like, Jacob reserved it.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just a lot of, like, I think.
Should we just come in guns blazing one time? Sons of Gary vests? Who made those rockers online? Someone had a great, was it Kevy Kev? Who made the ones with, or was it Dan, someone tweeted at us where they had the.
The parrot head?
Yeah,
the parrot head. Oh, look, I can't remember off the top of my head, but
I say we come in rocking those and just fucking beat it, Fuglesang. I say we come in like Jackass with those buzzers and take a piece of his hair off.
Yeah, maybe.
He's got gorgeous hair.
He does have gorgeous hair, and I think it's a bit of a dye job. I think there's a lot of gray in there.
You think he's going Teddy Danson last couple seasons of Cheers?
I think he is. I feel like the roots are coming in all gray.
I remember when I learned that about Ted Danson, it fucking shocked me, because that was before the internet. And then they were like, do you know Ted Danson dyes his hair for Cheers? And they're like, shut up.
Totally gray.
Showed a gray. You're like, no way.
Yeah, as soon as he showed up.
Right, Ted Danson the white. the gray. I should have said the gray.
I feel that. Jacob, your thoughts at all? I feel like there's no rush. And I feel like they're kind of doing like, oh, yeah, you guys are going to come dick around and do your little thing now? All right, we'll jump out of here. And it's like, there's never seems to be a real. I see they still.
There
like,
it is. It was Daniel Plainview. Or at, I can't remember his name.
That's awesome.
God, those are awesome.
As they come out, like, they'll stop doing, like, a few more sentences of conversation.
Yeah, it's
where
a
it's
casual
like, let's get the fuck out.
They take their time.
So what do you think? Do you think we come in and go, hey, all of you, time to fuck off. And sons of Gary's are here, and I got two words for you. Beat it. And the damn liberal left Nancy's. I don't know if you guys want to jerk each other off with your damn equal opportunity employment. I know you guys are hanging out here sucking each other's stink pickles. You want to walk in here? I know you guys are laying belly to back. I know you've become the beast with two dicks, but can you do it in Studio 4, perhaps? Hey, if you want to have Hydra sex, that's fine with me, but it's an abomination. That's enough, sissies. Enough of your damn Castro district assless chap talk. It's men time. You clams are going to hang out and lay stomach pancakes on each other. Why don't you take it over to Studio 4 where they like that kind of shit at out? Okay. Enough of you guys gurgling with boy batter. Time for you to get out of here. Yeah, I think we should just come in hard.
We're joking. It genuinely bothers me, and I'm not. This is where me and Dan differ. I feel like Dan, if it maybe not in this situation, but you are definitely like a step up and say something before I am.
Yeah,
I mean, it's funny. I was telling. I said to Christina that day, I keep busting her balls about being a pussy.
Yeah.
Like, she's, for sure, but I'm a pussy, not out of fear. I guess maybe some partially out of fear, but I am I don't like asking for money I'm owed. I don't like all that. Yeah. And by the way, it's because I feel like the person's going to be shitty with me, and then I have to go shitty. And then it's like, now we're in a fight.
I have a
Because I'll be so much more angry that I was like, I don't even want to have this talk at all. But I kind of have to, you know what I mean?
You go, if I go 0 to 60, you go 0 to Bruce Lee. Like in Game of Death, not Game of Death, Fist of Fury, where they rip the necklace off him. Where he's like, I won't fight. And they tear the necklace. And he's like, just beats the fuck out of the whole ice factory. That's what you do where you're like,
yes,
I don't want a problem. I don't want a problem.
I don't,
and then they push you and you're like, ah!
Yeah, then the Hulk out.
Then you crowd work him to death. Yeah. What have you, you're like, what have you been up to?
What do you do? What a loser. That's a job for a teenager.
You just keep going in on him. Where's your mom? Sucking dick. This guy's destroying me.
I bet your sister's fucking a black guy.
He starts bleeding. Fugle Sang starts bleeding out of his brain.
I don't like it. I don't like it at all. It bothers me, and I want to say, like,
but I understand the energy that you're talking about.
I don't enjoy that energy. I feel the whole thing's. I feel like they don't think about it for 3 seconds past walking out this door or us showing up. But I almost feel like that's the problem in it. I feel like they don't have an urgency where it's like, oh shit, well, we gotta be out the door here at 5.
Yeah.
That would weigh on me. If we had a show that came in here at 8 o'clock, that came in here right after us, it would be weighing on me that way. I'm like, let's wrap our show at like 3 of and get the fuck out of here.
Let me give you an example. When Sam Roberts had his show from 9 to 12, or it was like, I think it was after Opie and Jim, and then Sam would do his show. When was it? I mean, Lou, you were around for that.
Yeah, it would be after the show. I was doing the show before. It would be like Race Wars.
Yeah.
Would be on. And then they would leave a kind of a mess for him.
But before Sam moved to nights, when Sam was in afternoons, I remember I did it once and Bennington was coming in. And we were having like a great time. And he's like, all right, we got to get the fuck out of here. I'm like, why? He's like, 10 minutes, Bennington's coming in. So at 10 minutes, he stopped the show and got everyone out of there.
Yeah.
So there was like this, like, we got to fuck off. Someone's coming in. This is someone's.
Yeah,
and then, you know.
I don't. And they're done before 5. When
do they end?
They're done.
5 o'clock?
They're always just sitting around, dicking around.
I'll give them if they end at 5.
Probably end a couple of minutes before 5.
Yeah, like 5 minutes before.
4:58 or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, you're right, Jay. Let me just work on it, all right? Let me take care of it.
Yeah, no.
No, it's true.
I'm telling you, I'm not. You are. We are a million miles away from me saying anything about it.
Oh man, but you know what?
But on the radio, and this, where I can grieve here, and probably yes, apply that to see what you can do to handle that. But I really don't. I hate.
Let me tell you about the vibe.
We can't complain about the vibe to anybody, but like.
But you talked about how you're bad at conflict.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you right now what's going to happen now from this. What's going to result is the thing that bothers me the most, where there's weird energy at all. Because I'm like a kind of person, like, I'll get confrontation out of the way to clear the energy, or the vibe. To be like, hey man, fuck this shit. Either, like, I've said that to people before at bars and they've been blown away, where I'm like, hey, if there's any shittiness between us, let's just go outside and fight. Because then there won't be shittiness between us, because then we'll punch each other in the face and then you'll get that out of you. So I'd rather do that than sit there and be, you know, like stared at, or like, you know, there's a person, I'm not going to bring it up on
air. For long stretches of time.
Long stretches of time. There's a person that we know in comedy that I have a problem with. I won't say male or female, but they've been going around saying shitty stuff about me, and I'm the
tight her.
Yeah, I would love to. But there's a part where I know my own self, and I just need to let that go.
I just assume it's a girl.
Yeah.
I go, fight her.
I
wonder if it's a man or a woman. Whatever it is, bite it.
Yeah, bite it and kick it. I go, Jay, is that your advice? You go, got a tattooed on my calf, bud. Bite it or kick it. But there's a thing of, I need to learn how to be cool with just that energy being out there of them not liking me. And I'm telling you, like, I don't mind coming in here and being like, hey, guys, can you fuck off early? If it would kill the energy. But if this changed it to where we're walking down the hall and I see him, I'll be like, this is fucking weird.
I'll nose to nose him in the hallway. I don't give a shit. I'll go for the physical.
Well, no, I'm fine with it. I'm saying like the continuation of the weird.
Yeah, no, me either.
I'd rather
headbutt him in the hallway.
Okay. Yeah, well, you are going 0 to Bruce Lee.
Yeah, but no, I don't want anything really to happen. But yes, and I'd love it to be, and that's why I'm saying, like, almost, I still have the lack of confrontation where I'm like, in the complaint, obviously, you don't have to say that they don't, I feel like we're being disrespected.
Yeah.
It can just be like, it's like, hey, we kind of, like, for our scheduling, we got to start the thing, like, by 5 after 5, we have to be recording.
I do like the
we need a few minutes to set up.
I do like the higher ups getting a memo that says we feel we're being disrespected.
Right? Yeah.
I'm just telling you, President Sirius, I just feel like I'm getting mad disrespected when I come in there. No, you know what I mean?
Well,
like,
fuck your bitch.
I don't do politics.
Oh, Hugo Sang, here we come.
First off, fuck you in the hair you die.
We're just starting. Ron Reese, little bitch, hanging by your side.
Oh, you didn't think we're gonna do this?
You claim to be a player,
but I fucked your wife. I'll watch the Defiant Ones. I'll go after
Hell
who
yeah.
I like.
That's right.
I mean, it would crush me.
Leah Bonham on the show today, walking out all bottom heavy with that booty cracking. Hey! How's it go? That's why I fucked Leah Bonham. If I didn't.
But,
if I didn't fuck Leah Bonham.
That's why I changed your screen. That's why I changed your screensaver, you liberal motherfucker. Take money.
Actually, that's part of the funny thing in here is like today Leah Bonham was here and Ryan Reese. And it's like, I know them and I like them but both. So it's as they're walking out, there's like that. But I feel like they're getting my flack from me being like, nah, this isn't your guy's fault, I understand, but this guy you just did his show,
you're doing
fucking
the,
treat me like a straight-up bitch right now.
You're trying to do the capped anger where you're going, hey, good to see
it's
you,
great
too.
To see you, Ryan. It was great to see both of them.
I'll see you guys. No, where you guys at later today? Okay. All right, John. And John, if you could, can I have a word with you? That would be great. Hey, John, can I take you, can we talk real quick? Just do that,
John, do me a favor. Give me five reasons right now why I shouldn't just fucking put you through this portal.
No, you always got to ask with a question. You go,
do you not respect me?
He goes, what?
You don't respect me, do you?
He goes, I don't know what you're talking about, Dan. Well, that's just, you know, we've gone out of our way to reserve the studio at 5. I mean, we don't go to live at 6, but we're also doing a show at 5. So the question comes back down and I just need an answer real quick. Do you not respect me?
Dan, I don't want any problems. I'm just doing Dan, I don't want any problems here.
I'm not saying there's going to be problems. I just got to figure out the answer to this question right now.
I mean, this is what Trump wants, is two brothers. First off,
you're not my brother. I've never met you before. I don't even think that's your real last name. So here's what we're going to happen. I'm going to tell you three things that are going to happen. Number one, I'm going to start showing up every day at 5:05. Number two, if you're in the room, I'm going to go nuclear.
Dad, listen, I'm going to adhere to all these things. Ryan Reese, go low, I go high.
Yeah, dude, I think it'll be fine. Jacob will talk to it. Jacob will make threats.
John, it'd be a shame if you went in one day and one of the lights was unscrewed. And it just kind of dropped on you.
He also really wails the lights in here. It's like a goddamn terrarium when we walk in.
He's got lizard lighting. He goes in. He's just on a hot rock.
He's got a hot rock in the middle of the table here. He goes, the debates, your thoughts.
He goes, is there collusion in Russia? I don't. Next question. What's better?
Is POTUS guilty of treason?
Yeah. What's
gets a fly?
Is Donald Trump Jr. actually meeting with Russian intelligence? Now, second question, which part of the rock is hotter? Ooh, I think I found it.
Now, your argument here is that John Fugelsang has no respect for us, treats us like bitches, like chumps. I wanted to get around the studio because someone just walked in. That John Fugelsang treats the bonfire like a couple of bitches.
Just because we're not intellectual.
He doesn't treat us like we're fucking five whites and a black. He treats us like we're five blacks and one white. Jay, that's how he looks at us. He
treats us like a bunch of roller rink whores.
What am I, some bowling alley bar slag? Fuck you.
I'm sorry, I don't pay attention to the news.
I'll let you get through here.
Someone lead over Jay to work on a computer while Jay's trying to talk is not the best.
I just wanted to get my leg free.
I
just want to be in the studio at 5:05.
I think we'll be fine.
By the way, Fugelsang, he's infected our call system now. Literally, it says POTUS Politics, all the phone lines. He's fucked us so hard and so royally. Is he still in the building?
It goes back.
Jacob, lure him in here. I'm going to beat him up.
It goes back in a time where he's on the phone with two Garys going, I think you need to leave your kid.
Dude.
He's the start of all of this. Like when you find out in Tim Burton's Batman that it was the Joker that killed his parents.
Dan, can we get him in here?
Let's go on the show.
Can we get him in here? And I want you to give him that rap you gave.
Yeah, what?
You go, do I look like a bitch?
Yeah, that's funny. You go, hey, John, I don't know if we've ever talked about this. Do you think I pee sitting down? No.
Oh, that's weird. Knows, but you think it's a...
It's weird that
you... Is my pussy a little puffy?
Yes.
So I don't think you have a pussy. He goes, oh, that must be my dick. A man. Treat me like one.
Hey, I should just, I just got a quick question for you, Fugues. What color is my labia? It's so weird just because it's,
I love it. I'm going to start doing mine with, the fake karate moves I'm going to have to do afterwards.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm like, hey, Fugles, I got a question for you. Do you see lipstick on my face? Yeah. Is there any? No? Oh, it's probably because I'm not a bitch. Chop to the throat.
Okay. I like that better. Yeah, you got to keep that coming different where you go, oh, hey, John, real quick, if I could talk to you by High Heat, the High Heat studio. Yeah. Yeah, I just wanted to know if you're going to give me back that Barbie I let you borrow. Oh, I didn't let you borrow a Barbie? Then stop treating me like a little girl. Yeah!
Double chest punch.
Yeah.
What did he do? How did he fix it? Oh, did he have to turn off all the Fuglesang shit?
Pretty much, yeah. It was still logged in DC somehow. They changed it over to the DC.
Angry Baby hates us when he has to come in here.
And that's because fucking angry. He is Angry Baby. Puppy Monkey Baby.
Puppy Monkey Baby.
Puppy Monkey Baby. Hey, our phone screen seems to be all wrong. Puppy Monkey Baby. Okay. Is that, do I hit Control Alt Puppy Monkey Baby? Puppy Monkey Baby.
I thought Angry Baby was going to be the best nickname, but man, you just shot the wad on that one.
Puppy Monkey Baby when he comes in. That's him. Baby. He's so angry.
Yeah.
Puppy Monkey.
Puppy Monkey Baby. Puppy Monkey Baby.
That's the guy who comes in here. Puppy Monkey Baby. He hates us.
Just pure hatred when he walks in. We are not making a lot of friends.
Why are we so not popular?
Hey, Puppy Monkey Baby, can I talk to you real quick outside? Hey, did someone not clean your cage? He goes, what? Did someone not clean your cage? Oh, okay, because you're treating me like an animal. I'm about to treat you like an animal, so...
I like sending Puppy Monkey Baby back with a message.
There you go.
Fuglesang, Puppy Monkey Baby. Guess what? Puppy Monkey Baby.
They don't like you. Puppy Monkey Baby.
Bonfire's talking mad shit. Puppy Monkey Baby.
They feel disrespected. Puppy Monkey Baby.
They said something about you're treating them like bitches, and then they start doing examples of that. Puppy Monkey Baby.
I love that. Hey, hey, John, can I talk to you real quick? Hey, where's your furry coat? What? Oh, your furry coat and your cane and your big hat. What do you mean? Oh, because I thought you were trying to pimp us. Because it feels like you're trying to pimp us. Yeah!
Hey, John, does my hair look better in a ponytail or pigtails, you think? Oh, neither? Oh, it's probably because I'm a man. Headbutt! Yeah.
Glasgow kiss!
Flying scissor!
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm... All right, well, what are you going to do, Jacob? What's the... I mean, I think we've thrown the gauntlet down. Puppy Monkey Baby's going back with that info. He's going to say something.
Yeah, easily. I bet.
I feel like he's fucking... Like, that guy seems like he's boys with Fuglesang.
And I bet he's in Ben and Deb's pocket. I bet he's on the side of everyone that's against us.
From the fucking day we walked into the studio... And John Fuglesang gave me a tour of it like it was his fucking bedroom. He was letting us borrow. It made me fear. He literally assigned to me that are his and with his idea. This
he gave you an Airbnb.
A surge protector, which I refused to use because he made such a big deal. Because we brought, I swear to you, he goes, yeah, we brought, that's ours, but you could feel free, you could use it. He said you could use it. It's a fucking surge protector.
He gave you an Airbnb tour.
Oh, he goes, I did
all right,
not
if
like
you
it.
Stay here real quick. That light, little thing. Also, I like to have the lights on as bright as possible on me. I like to be blinded, but also.
I recycle nothing here ever because he told me he made a thing to make you get recycled. I don't give a shit.
No, don't take it out on planet Earth.
Oh, I am. It's going down to Earth. Earth, you got Fuglesang to thank for this. Lou is here. You came in and I told you how frustrating that was.
Yeah.
Do you remember the first day we were in the studio? I go, man, I'm already like, the vibe is very much. There. I mean, we always come in. The pylons are never ours. It's fine. Care. Gives a shit.
But it's not his either.
No, I know. I'm just saying, like, but there's, as far as, like, our stamp on the studio.
You know,
I mean, we're the best thing happened in Studio 5. I'll never, I mean, we have to be at least fun, fun-wise.
We need pylon interns.
We need pylon interns.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just to hold flags up like Game of Thrones.
I love John's perspective on this whole thing. It's probably a 180 from what you guys are feeling.
Yeah, he's like, oh, man, I'm sorry. I was just hanging out for a
I had no idea. We ended our show and we were just a couple of minutes.
Yeah, we were just shooting the shit afterwards.
I'm telling you, it's not even, I said that. I already pointed that out. I said, he's not thinking about it.
But to get us back to the topic that we're going to talk about today, but that is true, is that is something that we as overthinkers take, where we take like that, like, oh, they're disrespecting me because of this. Very few dumb people do that. They don't, like, look into it that much, or they'd probably be like, oh, you're just hanging out. Like, good looking dudes who are kind of dumb are just like, thanks for hanging out, man. Is it cool if we jump in? Violent dumb dudes are like, I'm going to do something about it. Like, they walk in with a bottle and like, Kah! Ah! But you know what I mean?
Somebody's going to die tonight. Yeah.
Hey, Fuglesang!
I'm just walking out with a knife scraping against the wall.
Both walls?
Yeah!
Down the hallway?
You ready to play?
You got one of those, you got a fucking Clockwork Orange eye?
Hey, Fuglesang! Time's up!
Fuglesang!
Hey, John, can I talk to you real quick? Yeah, I just want to know, should I get a landing strip or just bikini wax? What? For my pussy. Oh, I don't think you have a pussy. Oh, cool. Then why are you laying over me with your arms locked trying to fuck me like I have one? Get out of our studio. or I'm going to take you to Pound Town and not the fun type.
Do you want to, Do you want this to be full girlfriend experience where I kiss you while you fuck me? Or so do you want me to just pay face down the pillow just shutting my stupid bitch yap? Mm-hmm. Because I just want to know, how do you like your ladies? Because that's what you're treating me like. Yeah. A goddamn lady. Nutshot!
Hey, John, can I talk to you real quick? I just wanted to tell you that I don't know if you know, but Jay and I have never been to Japan. Why would I think you guys are going to Japan? Oh, because you're treating us like a couple geishas. So,
yeah! Leapfrog sidekick! That was me coming in over your hit.
Whoa! Out of nowhere! Yeah. All right, but we were, before the break, we were talking about, well, we watched Peter North's cum shot compilation, which we found out can be fun if you do laser noises. But the reason I brought up Fuglesang was because he is a handsome man, and he does have nice hair. Uh-huh. And it could be handsome guy confidence.
Sure.
That is the reason he's treating us the way it is. Where he's like, you guys still want to fuck me. I'm like, I totally do. Even though I feel disrespected, I still want your approval.
I love Christine, and I bake.
Olivia Newton-John doesn't just get physical. She gets emotional. It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big Jay Oakerson, and this is the Lost Tapes of The Bonfire. And I'll tell you right now,
lots happened through that commercial break.
Through time and space, Dan Soder's became a John Fuglesang ally. I didn't know he was a soda-holic. That's what I'm calling my fans from now on. That's actually not.
I'm telling you, I get nothing but the bad vibes from that guy.
So,
I think here's the thing, by the way. I think he likes you. I think he does not. Something about him does not like me.
You just feel like he doesn't like you.
Dude, I'm telling you, and Lou did a fucking flip-flop, too. This little queen bee over here who fucking got all hot in the box for fucking tall, handsome Fuglesang.
Fuglesang walked by and went, hey, Lou, is that a different plaid shirt? He went, it is.
Thanks for noticing.
He goes, hey, Lou, you smell terrific today.
Complete me.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, Lou flipped, too, but Lou was right here when he came in. He goes,
I like how immediately you changed the tone.
That's the tone. He goes, yeah. He goes, we'll make sure not to leave the place a pigsty for you, huh?
There was a huh?
I don't want to swear to the huh.
Okay,
that's the correct vibe, though, but I...
That is the vibe. Okay, and then really just like, and he goes, so you guys are like every day now, huh? Every day. And we were like, no, it's just 3 days. He goes, oh, I just thought you guys were every day at this point. And they were like, no, it's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. He's like, no, okay. And then you came in. And he lit up.
Yeah.
He's a soda maniac.
He's a soda-holic. It's like when the frog in the WB where he doesn't sing, where he's like, yeah.
Brop. And then I come in, he's like, hello, my baby. Hello, my darling. Hello, my ragtime gal.
Gal.
He goes, Dan Soder, I love your radio. I come in, he's
like, oh, I jacked off to your billboard in L.A., he says.
Well, that's what he said. He goes, you have a billboard in L.A. for the Netflix, the stand-ups, and I didn't know that.
He brought you good info, and now you're just on his team.
Hey, crazy story, Dan. Before your dad died, I actually had dinner with him, and he told me he's proud of you.
You're singing the Fugelsang song.
I just think he's a handsome man who has good points.
That's fine. I'm thinking about rebooting a lot of my friendships. All my friendships.
You know, I'm ride or die, even if he doesn't.
I'm going to start a new life on like the Upper West or something. Oh, upper West side of
that. That'd be crazy. I'd go, hey, I was on 87th, and I swear to God I saw Big J.
Because you started over.
Yeah, now he calls himself Large Mark.
Large Larry Ogerson.
Large Larry Ogerson. I go,
still Ogerson?
Yeah. I go, you just need to drop Ogerson? There you go, that's Large my new life.
Hello, my baby. Hello, my
That's Fugelsang when he sees me.
Oh, Dan's here. Ha-cha-cha-cha. Fuck him.
Dude, we were laughing so hard in the office because you told me you were like, and out of nowhere he followed me on Twitter.
Yeah.
And you still feel like it's a bully move.
Yeah, I think he did it because he thought I was you at first. He's like, oh, wait, no, it's the other guy.
Shit, I can't follow him.
He followed me back,
the little bitch.
Little fucking fat oinker's going to sit there and cry squeaky tears into a fucking handkerchief.
I don't want to give him bacon tears. He's just vicious. He's vicious when I'm not around. Dude, I didn't know he was doing that to you. You go, yeah, it's pretty bad. He goes, what's wrong? Little pork chop gonna cry? Jesus Christ, Fugelsang.
Hey, Piggy. Yeah. Piggy gonna cry?
He goes, oh, what's wrong? You need to crawl out of your slop to do a radio show? I come in, he goes, I mean, you guys are legitimately hilarious. I'm like, what the fuck? What the hell's happening here?
Oh, is this what it sounds like when the pigs cry?
And then I walk in, hey, what's going on, guys?
Oh, bro, what's up?
Hey, dude. Saw you on a billboard in L.A. It was like about time, right?
You go, what?
Yo, fucking Tubbs was telling me you guys aren't every day yet. That's fucking sickening, man. You should be every day. You're that talented. But you're so talented, you're probably busy with other projects.
He goes, he walks in.
I get it. Anyway.
He goes, what's up?
Pink belly, fat boy. All right, Soder, we'll catch you later.
God, are you going to cry now?
Yeah, he goes,
come on, Soder, cry, baby. Cry,
Soder, keep killing him. Hey, watch out for the beaties. All right, I'll see you later. I go, Jesus. That's what I just hear him making that noise in the hallway. I go, why does he do that?
Why is he doing that pig crying?
Why is this little piglet pig crying?
Anyway,
before
we all chose our allegiances differently.
Oh, hey, you know me, I'm ride or die with you. If you don't like Fugelsang, I'll still shave his head.
It's not true. You're all about him. All about him now.
You get caught in that charming beam.
I've seemed to have avoided it somehow. I've avoided the charming beam. This is the episode still. We haven't fully gotten through these porn male porn star.
Well, I mean, we didn't even get fully through Mr. Pete's.
I know. Because it was making me too happy, everything he was saying.
It was making you angry happy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go back. Can you go back to it, Christine? Christine's just trying to hack into Fugelsang's email. He looks like an awkward employee at
self-made man, big Fugelsang fan.
Yeah. I think John Fugelsang's got the key to life. Also, I'm a go-getter. So if you hire me at this insurance company, the way he's dressed looks like he works at an insurance company. At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and Facebook. If you want to see the videos we're watching.
God damn it, Dan. He gave me the vibe that he knows I fucking talked.
Is that what it was?
And it went back
that was
to...
That was the vibe he gave you.
Out of nowhere goes, hey, we'll do our best to keep the room nice and tidy.
We won't
leave our mess. What do you say, Lou?
We'll
do our best to clean up our pigsty before we leave. That was unsolicited. I didn't ask for that.
Did he make eye contact with you when he said pig?
I came in like a poon and just act like I was on my phone and stood over here to let them pass.
Yeah.
And they started asking me a bunch of questions.
He goes like this. He goes, who are you texting?
What's up, Chops?
He calls you Chops. He goes, "Ah, looks like the butcher let you out early today, huh? You slice of ham?"
"Hey, Chops.
I'm surprised you guys have a Jew producer, goes, considering you're made of pork."
"You, hey, chin up. You got a problem with the way we leave the studio?"
"Hey, I didn't know, I knew you were a pig. I didn't know you were a canary bird. I didn't know you sang."
"Oh, I'm getting hungry for a BLT. Just breathe in your salty skin. You tell HR on me again."
"Threatening Hugo.
I'll fucking make bacon strips out of you, Tubbs."
"Pink belly."
"Hey,
heads up. Heads up. If you, you rat on me again, I'm going to turn you into a goddamn pork chop."
Yeah, he didn't realize that Jacob ratted on him, really. I made a public thing. I'll fight him.
Dude, I would love if after this episode's air, if we walk in and there's just a mouse trap hanging from the ceiling after they leave, and it just says snitch with it fucking locked out.
It's hanging from, there's a mouse trap hanging from a noose.
Yeah, and he goes,
Jacob goes, "Hey, John, we were here a little earlier yesterday, and that noose with the mouse trap." He goes,
"Oh, do you know what that means?"
I don't know.
"Oh, you don't know? Because I think you know where HR is. Because you sure as shit walked in there and bitched about me and my family."
"What'd you say, Jacob?"
I just asked my boss to ask them, you know, to leave a little early."
"Who's your boss?"
"Don."
"Oh, Don Wicklund. Oh, he's got such an unpleasant, he's got such a boss face.
Cowboy boots Don?
He definitely told them with an air of like, hey guys, come on. Stop fucking these guys over.
Hey, we got a lot of money in these two idiots.
Get out of the goddamn room. Don't be a fuck about it.
Hey, Fugelsang, I let you talk. Now you let my boys talk."
And that's, he probably gave them dressed them down a little bit. And now they came back here and they assume it's me. I look like the one who's going to run and tell.
You don't, though.
I don't. You're right.
Jacob does.
I know, but they're,
I think Fugelsang's just carrying energy because you know what I think it is? I think he's threatened by you. I don't think he's threatened by me. That's why he's nice to me.
Best hair in studio?
Yeah.
Maybe.
But also, I think he's just got an air of, like, the gravity of the room, you know? He's used to being the gravity of the room of his show. You're the gravity of the room of this show.
No, I don't think I'm the gravity. I don't know if I have that kind of maybe I do. I don't think I have that kind of presence. It's not even that he strikes me as he does.
Maybe he's just trying to pick a fight with you.
I don't know.
He goes, meet me in between 47th and 48th at the waterfall. 4 p.m., I'm going to fucking break your face.
Half floor.
Yeah, no, but on, you know what I'm talking about in the street?
By the waterfall. Oh, yeah.
He goes, hey, meet me at the waterfall, 3:30 p.m. tomorrow. I'm going to break your fat fucking face. You go, Jesus, Fugelsang.
My ring's outside, Chops. Pink belly.
Yeah. Body glove. He goes, surf the tide. Pow. Ow, man.
Lou, you don't feel that?
No, I think it's like the, he's being like, hey, I'm a comedian too, you know. Let's talk shop over here. Hey, Soots, I saw your fucking billboard. Good punchlines or whatever you guys say.
I think he's saying we're all comedians here.
Because he's a comedian. And he wants to be like one of you guys, like a good comedian, not just a fucking political dick bag.
Let me see his comedy.
Ah, dude, this is going to go down a dark place.
But he's also...
That's why I was dead silent for about 15 seconds of thinking.
You did the sniper breath. You went,
put it on.
Sure. Listen, man, this will escalate it to a war.
All right, don't put it on. Now everyone at home really wants us to put it on.
Maybe just a little bit. Maybe just a taste. Then we go to the porn star interviews.
I was going to say, if Christine was funny at all, she would just start playing this and said it was his comedy.
Yeah.
John Fugelsang's comedy just Mr. Pete's the rest of his interview.
He goes,
oh, man, crushing ass.
I'm pretty aggressive. I don't like to watch myself. I'm not that crazy.
But I'm pretty aggressively not crazy.
I'm just pretty aggressive.
I'm aggressively sane.
I'm just aggressively, like, I'm aggressively happy to be here.
Let's not watch John Fugelsang's comedy.
Well, let's watch Mr. Let's go
now back. You want to? All right, Dan wants to.
I didn't say that. I said let's watch Mr. Pete.
Dan's all goosed up to watch it.
I mean, not really, but
Jacob. I mean, Lou's giving me a thumbs down. He already says he knows it sucks.
I'm not into politics. That's all. Political humor, especially.
Well, Lou, for the record, can I theater the mind? But we're not giving a thumbs down. I'm making that. Yeah. You just accepted that. I go, Lou's giving a thumbs down. Like he already knows it sucks. Lou's like, that's not my thing. you accepted it completely.
I took improv class at Burton Community College, guy. I know where you were going with that. I was playing along.
Yeah, he was yes anding you.
God.
Thank you so much, Lou. That's a guy you want in your corner.
Lou?
Oh, man.
Yes and Lou?
Oh, yeah, I want Lou in the... Yes and Lou.
Oh, you a little Lou Yes and Witzky?
And then we had to come in today to face real reality. Yeah. We're going to have to cross paths with Jonathan Fugelsang again.
Who did not find any of the bits that we did on this show funny.
Can't say that I'm even mildly concerned. You know what bothers me about it? And I will say this, and upon my pleading with him almost online.
Which we talked to him via DM.
On direct messages. Pleading with him, he clearly did not at all listen to, at all. He didn't listen once to anything we said.
Well, it was pretty clear because he was upset. He sent us a DM.
Somebody told him something.
Yeah, it was clear there was all third-hand knowledge because even in one of the DMs I had with him, he was like, well, people have been telling me. And it's like, well, you can't understand a bit. Comedy's immediately fucked up secondhand. Anytime I've tried to tell, I'm a comedian, and when I try to tell other comedians jokes to my friends, I know I fuck it up in some small way. Even if I know the bit, like when Attell does a new joke, and I see Becky Owen, I'm like, oh, Attell did this joke, and it's just like, that's not right. That's not the right way it went. But, as a comic, you'd be like, oh, I get why that was funny. You can't hear something secondhand and then assume that it's you can't assume that that's exactly what it is, because obviously you're going to be, like, wrong.
So he approached us with a vibe of, like, how do you describe it?
I mean, are we being dead honest? With the air of the most, it was the most pretentious, like, I was furious. People were at the DC.
I wasn't even furious.
I was mad. Yeah. I was at the DC Draft House, and I read the first DM before I went on stage. And listen, the first DM was like, I can understand. I thought he listened and was like upset because he listened and he didn't like it. So I was like, hey man, I'm sorry. We were joking around. If we went too far and like pissed you off, we weren't trying to. We were just trying to be funny. That was basically the feel of my first DM. Then I got off stage after the show, and read the response DM, and I was just like, oh man, you didn't listen. And that's when I was mad, because I'm like, now you're bringing some shit where you're upset at us for not listening.
Well, it's weird to hit us up with that, hearing what was said.
Yeah.
By the way, I adhere to almost everything I said. I didn't take much, if any of us shit on John Fugelsang, honestly.
We made fun of ourselves for being spineless.
And the joke was also making fun of me, the bleat, bleat. Like him calling me fat and him being handsome.
And then
most of the joke. But
the joke was that he lit up around me and was quiet around you.
Yes.
That was how the joke
was. And I stand clear to that fact, absolutely. I think it was weirdly like he's kind of head down.
Well, let me tell you who's not bright when he sees me anymore.
Old Johnny F? Old Johnny Fugues?
Oh, the Fugues does not like when Jacob and old Monster Voice walked in the studio.
He got weird. Now, Lou fucking fleed the scene.
Yeah.
I said, Jacob, I'm scared. I'm not going in.
Lou, by the way, secondhand made me a bitch. Because what Lou did, Lou finds me in the hallway and does an immediate turnaround. Like, he's like, oh, you're here, I guess, so we're going to the studio.
Yeah.
And I go, where's Eddie? He goes, I don't know, but he actually wants a face-to-face, Fugelsang. He wants a face-off. He goes, he's in the studio. I go,
take his face off.
He goes, he's in there. I go, all right. And then I realize we're taking the long way to the studio.
You guys went around.
I know.
Oh, Lou.
But that wasn't me. I was just following Lou. Like, okay, I'm talking to him.
You want
to
break me down? All right, I'm afraid. For the first time in my life, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Lou's afraid of John Fugelsang. Did this guy pick on you before we got here?
Well, I don't want to say the wrong thing. It's my fight, but I'll say something stupid.
It's not a fight. We made a joke and he got upset about it. And by the way, it was solved via text messaging.
Right, but he's so misinformed that he doesn't get it. He's so misinformed. I don't want to say anything that would fuck it up or make things worse. I just
Let me tell you,
it's going to get worse. It's going to get worse for sure.
Let me tell you,
people are going to feel it. I promise you that.
We found out we have a brave mouse in the room because I got down here and Black Lou and Jacob were hanging outside, and I go, what's up? What is going on? And Jacob goes,
fecal signs in there. You ready to go in?
He goes,
hey, Dan, today's the first day I fight back. He goes, there's a problem inside, but guess who's going to tackle it? Like a wheel of cheese. Let's go.
Black Lou, you can't be frightened of the situation at all.
Not at all.
Oh, not at all, no.
And by the way, and that's saying not at all, like, assuming that you are considered part of the enemy camp. Are you saying you're not nervous at all because you don't think he really associates you with us? Or are you saying with full responsibility to the bonfire, you're like, fuck this dude?
Oh, I'm definitely saying fuck this dude.
Yeah. I like it. Black Lou's there.
He does come off as pretty arrogant at times, though.
It's White Lou from Jersey. He was fucking pussed up on this one.
Well, I think Lou just doesn't want a conflict at work where he's here a lot more than we are.
Right, because we got to run into him all the time, which is all fine. I'll take one for the team, and I'm not really that afraid. But was I correct in that he was lingering around to have some kind of confrontation with you guys, not me?
Let me just say this in the most passive way possible.
Yeah, the douchey way, probably.
I don't know if he...
I'll ask this question right now.
I don't think he was...
What time was it when you guys walked in the studio?
5:10.
I wanted them fucking out at 5!
Yeah. but I walked in and it was like... and I think Jacob will back me up on this. It was... The energy was... Angry girlfriend who wants you to ask her what's wrong.
Yeah.
Pass aggressive, to say the least.
Was Jacob, is that right?
That's dead on.
He walked in and I go, hey, John. And he was like, hi. Hi.
Oh, okay.
Hi. And I go, hey, man.
So.
I just laughed and farted at the same time.
We could have brought you flowers.
So. Hi.
And so I walked over and I noticed the comment on the TV about Trump and I just brought it up and then he was like, that's for bad language. All right, great show. Have a great show. So he like, he was passive in a way where he was still being nice but in a shitty way. Yeah, right?
Yeah, I mean, it was a little weird.
It was weird. It's going to be weird.
You know, I've just become consumed with Christine today. Behind the curtain here, brought in her first guest ever, and one of them has just vanished. It has not come back here.
Christine's
he is just in the cockles of this place. I don't know if he's tackling anthrax while they're talking to Eddie Trunk in the other room. Or,
dude, that's so funny.
I don't know if you know this, but there's Medea's radio show is happening next to us.
Dude, that's
portal.
Way too beautiful.
I didn't realize he didn't come back from the bathroom.
Nope. Black Lou's out there. Black Lou. I think Black Lou might be gone now. He's gone. Beautiful.
It's the mist out there.
Yeah, I do.
Don't go out in the mist.
We're broadcasting live from the Sirius Satellite Studios.
And also, the guy's last words before he left the studio were, "And I don't know." And then he just left.
I'm waiting for him to walk into Fast Pitch or one of the ones around us.
No, that's a black guy. I thought maybe he was somewhere that was outside.
Now Christine's loose. Now he lost. Now he can't have video segment.
Oh, man.
Dude, he's just in Stern Studio pushing.
He's over at Howard Stern Studio rubbing his balls on the console. He's like, oh, my God. I hope that's not what's happening.
Yeah.
Although for the blowback on Christine, maybe worth it. That really might come. That's going to rain down shit on her. I have to go home.
Or what if he was so down he knew about the beef with the fugue and he's just up in his office tearing paper?
Oh, he's just got him tied. I've got him hog tied.
Yeah, he goes, I brought you guys a gift. There.
Hey.
Yeah.
I know you guys. Did I do good?
Yeah.
Or did I do crazy?
Dude, you kidnapped John Fugelson. Hey.
Did I do good or did I do bad again?
He goes, I think I hit him pretty hard in his head. He's just out in the chair. He's out of breath, though.
So he started yelling. And like,
he goes,
he just wouldn't stop yelling.
Jay, he's all out of breath. He goes, so I tried to talk to him, but he just wouldn't be reasonable. And I told him he needed to apologize to you guys.
And then my headaches hurt. I just wanted my head to stop hurting.
And then my headaches.
I just wanted my head to stop hurting.
Then my headaches came back. And then, and then I was like, you stop being meaner. You're going to give me a...
Is anybody else? It's like 1,000 trombones going off in my head. I have to hurt. I have to hurt again.
No, 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 no away. Oh, God. Oh, God, he's dead. Oh, God.
He's going to come back in wearing Christine's dress.
Hey, everybody. Sorry I'm late.
Sits at the computer.
So, what videos we watching today, guys?
The laugh's perfect. He talented, Mr.
Did
Ripley.
Did we just find our new impressionist producer?
Hey! Oh, now I can do voices with someone. Yeah! We were worried about you. We thought you wouldn't kidnap John Fugelsang. Oh, okay. We're glad you're back. Oh, no. Grab the headphones, dude. You're good. So basically, I think we're going to have to deal with this passive aggressiveness for the future until it just blows up into a full conversation.
Don't have a gripe with it. I'm fine with it, I guess. I feel like something's got to be said.
Yes, that's why I didn't want to come in. Who the fuck's going to say it?
You, Lou. Lou, I nominate only you.
If you write it, I'll say it. But he
really
doesn't give a fuck about me. He doesn't look me in the eyes. He cares about Dan, really.
Can that be the rule forever?
No. One time, one off. Only one time I'll do that.
But that you'll do if we write something down, he'll say it? Yeah.
By the way, I'm going to let him know if we ever have to hire somebody else on this show ever, I'm going to say the rule is always going to be the main thing is if we write it, you say it. That's just going to be a line in a contract.
That has to be
if
the
we write
thing.
It, you have to say it out loud.
If we write something, you have to say it.
Okay. Here's our good new segment.
I mean, no, you guys are all grandfathered in. Y'all are good. I'm talking about new blood.
New blood, if we write it, they have to say it.
Mm-hmm.
I want to get to this first. That's with you doing the ripping knifers.
Dude, I wish I looked like a beard. I didn't have a beard like that, but Alaska Dan, I agree.
I came into I didn't move any of I don't think. Black Lou, is any of this yours over here?
These two are mine, yes.
They are yours. Pretzel sticks or not. Pretzel sticks. Glass of water, all these things on the counter when we came in.
It's a shot at you, bro. He loves me.
It's a complete disrespect.
Even though we're kind of in a passive fight right now?
He doesn't love you.
You don't know that.
I do know that.
I'll win him back.
You want to win him back?
No.
What do you think? You think nothing of that?
Let's see if it happens again tomorrow.
It's just... Lou! I know you're terrified of this guy, but am I crazy?
I'm not terrified. I think you are crazy. Dan is correct.
What?
I think he has a hard-on for you.
Why?
Like, he's hurt that Dan is no longer friends with him.
I wasn't friends with him, though.
But I think he wants to take out his anger on you, Jay. You felt it. You felt the vibe.
Oh, I didn't like the vibe, for sure.
He doesn't like you for some reason, and I think that's what's making him mad. But he's more hurt because he likes Dan's comedy.
He's not a fan of mine.
I don't know that.
We don't know.
Why don't we just have him on?
Oh, that's what it is. He likes Dan's comedy. He doesn't like mine.
I think he hates you as a person, too.
Mine's too probably edgy and thought-provoking.
Yeah. Mine's simple, bland, palpable. He loves it. It's like pudding.
Like vanilla
pudding.
Sweater.
Yeah.
No, that's not... You think that's what it is? I mean, look...
I don't think that's what it is.
You could absolutely be into... Me and Dan's comedy is different that you could be into one person who's not the other person.
We should have him on the show.
He won't come on.
Yeah, Jay asked him to come on. He said, come dress me down on air.
I said, come give me a good talking to on the air.
I think it'd be fun to have him on. I think, you know, outside of that, you'll ask him? Ask him.
He won't do it.
I mean, let's see if Jacob's got any persuasiveness over him.
You did get Rice Head Fred in here.
Yeah, Liquid Todd hates Jacob.
Is Liquid Todd still around?
Yeah.
He's been outside every so often.
He's out the window mimicking the throat slit to Jacob.
Oh, my
ever
God.
Ever since that.
What do you call Jacob, our so-called producer? Remember that? You have some beefs in here, too, Jacob.
Yeah, don't think you just...
We'll fucking go. I don't give a shit. It'll be us against the whole goddamn SiriusXM. I don't give a shit. I'll go to every
channel. World? Bonfire versus the world? Yeah. Done. Because guess what's going to happen to the world? It'll burn.
Suck on that world.
I guess we previewed the Fugelsang tweet, so we should read it.
Yeah.
But someone brought it up to us on Twitter. Don't tweet at him. Who gives a shit? It's a fucking dumb mess. But someone tweeted at me that he wrote, going to get it all... Oh, damn it.
Going to get a tweet. Studio...
Sarah McPants wants us to kiss. That's old news.
Me and you?
Who doesn't?
Who doesn't want to see us fucking kiss?
God damn it, I lost the tweet. Did someone delete it?
I mean, I kind of know what it said.
He said he's going to make himself smell good for the funny guys.
No, he said he's going to make the place smell bad. And he goes, how about some Old Spice and Virginia Slims?
I love the smell.
But then he did hashtag...
Going to stink up the studio for the, quote, funny guys. Hope they like the smell of Old English in Virginia Slim.
Hashtag bang bang Fugelsang. I think it's just to be funny.
Well,
I don't think he's... Look, Maybe we're in a major feud. I have no idea.
I don't think so.
I'm not worried about it. I'd like to have him on the show because he really did. He reacted. I'd like to hear him say he reacted crazy. And then I want him to kiss me on the hand.
I just don't want any passive energy.
He wasn't. He's never been overly cool to me.
Okay.
It's always been a little weird.
Yeah.
Stand by that. Lou backs me up on that, even though he's terrified of John Fugelsang. He does not want any parts of John Fugelsang. For the record, John Fugelsang, you could walk right through White Lou. He is terrified still of you.
It's not my fight, soldier.
I think, oh.
Oh, buddy. Oh, now it doesn't bother you? None of these things bother you now, Lou.
It does. It does.
I thought you were my boy.
I am. I got your back, but I just can't. You got to go first.
No, you don't have my back. You have my three halls away.
Lou's like, just keep going, Jay.
Jacob's got my back.
You know what's so funny? If Lou's just walking down the hallway later and then Fugelsang turns the corner, Lou just throws everything in his hands at him. He's like, get away from me! It just runs away.
Oh, is that right? I see a Sarah McPants.
Sarah McPants, you are incorrect.
Oh,
she said, I think
one.
I can guess which one of Mike's sexes was the Terminator fuck. # Team Pellet. God damn
Remember
it.
Remember that?
Dude, I lived it.
Man.
I lived it.
Oh, man. You got, that's one thing as a comic or whatever, like a person who's like public like that, you can't be
mad.
Thin-skinned.
Nope.
And certainly can't be thin-skinned if someone's kind of like, hey, I find you attractive also. You can't be like, you bitch, blah, blah, blah.
Well, it's also kind of something is somebody that dates somebody that's a public guy. Like, you want girls to want to fuck him. Like, that's part of, like, that's
my
part of, like, you
now,
know, getting successful is, like, girls want to fuck you.
My girlfriend now makes fun of me because she's like, I'm glad I started dating you when you put the special out, hey, please date me, I'm single. That's what she calls my Netflix special. Hey, please date me. I'm single. And then it's like, ah, no. She's like, now I, you know, because I, but she's cool with it. She doesn't get upset. If you get upset by it, like if you got mad about all the shit Jay did, you'd be out. You'd be gone.
Yeah. Well, it's also.
What the fuck do I do?
It's not.
No, but I'm saying, like, you're on SDR. There's, like, porn stars and other shit. You know what I mean?
Christine whacked off a tranny on that show.
I didn't whack off a tranny. I touched her penis with my sweater around my hand.
Whacked off a tranny.
Wait, did you throw it away like a dead bird?
She's no, like, I just.
Did you touch her tranny?
Pretty bird.
She goes,
pretty
oh, bird. God. Oh, this thing fell far. Oh, this thing fell. Oh,
this
boy.
This is the Lost Tapes, yeah. Oh, this is a great one. I'm excited the Lost Tapes day starts off. Jacob's already shaking his head. No, Dan's got his head in his hands.
I now have my head in my hands. I'm trying to calm down. I'm trying to go.
DJ Lou's spinning around in a corner having an autistic freak out.
I'm trying to let the blood drain from my eyeballs.
We just had such a fucking awesome moment here for radio. But everyone's always different emotions about it. I don't know why I found it to be so great. We were not able to get into the studio right on time today. We were waiting.
Great musical.
You know, oh, yeah.
God damn it.
The Fugues was running, I guess, a little bit late in here. And then, so we had to come in the studio. And when we came in the studio, he and I believe his producer.
Actually, that guy's from Mystery Lou, Science Theater 3000.
Lou Pearlman.
Yeah.
His co-host, Lou Pearlman.
Yeah. Boy band producer extraordinaire.
There, pick up Fugelsang and the Fugues.
Yeah.
They were in here, and we said hello. It was definitely, you felt the tension of the awkwardness.
Oh, dude.
We said hello.
I haven't felt something like that since, like, legitimately before a fist fight.
That's
like,
great.
I'm about to fucking throw with this guy.
There was no fist fight.
No. Not at all. There was no fist fight at all, but the tension of there's going to be conflict.
That bump, 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 bump. The heart starts going a little bit.
And he's like, drop the backpack, and you're like, just keep your eyes on his hands. Or like,
yeah.
All right.
What are we doing here?
What's up, then? Do something, dude.
People are like, watch his kicks, Dan.
I go,
watch his kicks. He's got limber legs.
I just start going through my pockets. I go, Jay, hold my phone.
He started taking out your ear.
Jay, hold my phone.
Dan started Vaselining his eyebrows.
Yeah. And I started doing the jaw stretch.
Let's do this. Ugh. Neck cracks.
Mind if I put tassels on my shoes real quick?
We walk in. We said hello to him. He goes, guys, you know, I'm still getting a bunch of hate mail from your fans, which doesn't seem very our fans. Our fans, too, especially the core of fans, I mean, like, are against that sort of, like, you know.
Yeah, bullying?
Yeah.
Attacking someone for a radio bit?
Yeah. Well, yeah, so it's the kind of the way we said before, like, don't fuck up Corey. Don't ever go and fuck up Corey Feldman's performance.
No.
Like, don't impede his work. Like, go watch
don't
it.
Harass, don't
snicker to yourself.
Don't harass Roman and Sierra. Watch their videos and just kind of know that we're in on the joke.
Yeah.
Together. Don't harass anybody.
You're going to do what you're going to do as you listen to the show. However, I got to say what he said, I don't fully believe it. I think there was some embellishing there. I'm crazy.
The only thing was the fold of when you call down on something and you don't have immediate evidence.
Well, he says, even up until today.
He goes, today I had someone, one of your fans, threaten to fight me on the streets of New York City.
Yeah,
which
I said that happened today, but he said like someone threatened.
No, he said today.
Did he say earlier today?
And then I immediately said, give us that Twitter handle so we can reach out to this person. Find the tweet and tell them to fucking not knock that shit off.
Yeah, don't do shit like that.
Don't do shit like that.
Nobody threatened to be. Nobody wants Joe Fugle to say
we don't
beat
want
up
him
in the
beat
street.
Up. It's a joke
but
the entire
did.
Time. The whole radio feud is just that. It's just we say hello to him in the hallway. Jay tries to hilariously say hello to him in the hallway every time.
I give him a big hands up every time.
Johnny
boy.
Fugues. And it's a joke. And it's something that stays here at work. And if he is telling the truth. And people are threatening him.
Here's where I'm baffled by the interaction.
But hold on. Mm-hmm. If someone is threatening him, and he's telling the absolute truth that this is happening, then these people are dumb. You need to stop doing that. That's not this fucking show. This show isn't to threaten people in real life over some radio jokes.
I'm absolutely with you. Is that a new TV? Is that always there?
Yeah. It's been there for the entire time we've been in here.
Why is that never a thing I could see anything on?
I don't know.
I feel like that should be a situation we should work on. Now I'm seeing that I can see we can both see things directly.
Yeah, that would be pretty awesome.
I know we don't have.
Listen, we're going to get some improvement.
Deauville's probably on vacation at this point.
Deauville rule number 437. Puppy. Christmas starts in November.
Puppy monkey babies running around somewhere. I can't get these guys.
Dude, he's definitely dressed as an elf at the mall.
But. With people saying when he came in, first of all, we had a great interaction. Because said radio feud is all it really is at the end of the day. Look, and by the way, you could have genuine feuds with people. You know, there could be things that come up for real. Oh, Christine just walked into the studio. She is so behind on what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
He came in, or when we came in the studio, he said that. And you could tell, and by the way, I got to say I'm puzzled by this. And I'm not taking anything away. He's a stand-up comic. I know he is. He does stand-up comedy.
He's a comic. Comic of the TV show.
He's on Page Six. He's doing very well. He's been on, America's Funniest Videos for a while. He works. He's got a successful radio show. But I'm blown away by his lack of getting it with, like, the ball bust of the, you know what I mean? Like,
well, I think there's a certain, I think there is a certain, with radio, I think there are certain genres, even inside comedy, where there are, like, the guys who are funny at the loading dock, you know what sure. I mean? Versus like the guys who were smart and funny. I don't know. Does that make any sense?
Sure.
There's like people who are funny in the office with like, and I said like puns and shit. And then the guys are like, look at your pants. You fucking dumb.
Yeah. Usually it's a fat woman in a cubicle job.
Can you believe this one I just heard? Kathy doesn't like Mondays. I just tore it away. She's like, if Garfield was a human.
So,
yeah, some people are Dilbert calendars, and some people are fucking dead legs, you know? Like,
I'm with you, but when we came in and he started going through the actual, he's like, and people are saying you're complaining that, we leave stuff around, too. We don't try to leave stuff around. And you're almost, as he's saying it, you're almost like, John, I mean, really, it's like, honestly.
Does the chicken cry to cross the road? I mean, if this chicken's crossing a road, why? What's happening in that farm?
Isn't that how you feel as he's saying it?
It's a joke.
No, the best is he goes, and you say that I was trying to seduce you guys like chicks.
That was the part where I was like, I don't know if you caught how mad I got at that, but I go, come on.
But Travis was like chicks, and then we had to go, no, we were saying that you were hot for Dan and that you don't like me. Really, the big joke of that was making a bleaky fucking pig noise for myself. Yeah. And he's still like, well, Your people are threatening to attack me. And he goes, and then this thing, which I really, my least favorite part of the whole thing, he goes, and they can do it too, because I'm just some libtard, you know.
You saw how I react.
What do you say? Libtard pussy. I'm some libtard pussy.
Because I know your fans think I'm just some libtard, and I like, that's like where I'm like, dude, don't bring politics into this bullshit.
I don't even know that.
We've never even said that.
That term, I'm not even fully sure what that term, I mean, I can put it together, but I've never said the words libtard in my life. So he's putting in there, I have to say, and by the way, I could be proven wrong. And by the way, if anyone's out there threatening anybody physically, especially, I mean, come on. That's does another adult have to tell you don't do that?
Yeah. Do you have to?
But
is that where we're at now? Are we your babysitters?
If it needs to be the case, don't do that.
Do not.
However, I'm going to say I'm 65% sure that he's making the severity of this up.
That's why we're bringing this up, is because we want to know if it is true. Don't. Fucking stop doing that. And if it's not true, well then...
He's like, you guys make fun. I said, you guys go at us because we leave stuff in the studio. Like, constantly.
You're lucky.
Like, that's the thing, dude. I'm like, can you imagine
if we had a different angle on you? Ben and Deb, we should just bring Ben and Deb in as translators where they're like, yeah, these guys interrupted multiple of our shows. We've never had our callers call into shows, which don't do. Ben and Deb, because we know Ben and Deb are good sports. And we also know Deb also knows that Jacob and I are in love with her. Sure, Jacob should get her, but I'm greedy.
Oh, my God.
Someone sent a picture of Deb, and I was like, Vanilla Dan's about to smack it to this one. It was the one where she's bent over with cleavage. I was like, she's so hot.
Deb,
okay. Yeah, I'm all ramped up and mad. It's not Monday.
It's gonna screw up our. It's gonna screw up our. Our Terminator like timeline.
Well, I mean, that always happens with a show.
But I'm thinking today when we do live Monday, which was 3 days ago, four days ago, for you listening, I want to have people call in the show and say to look at Jacob and stuff.
They're not on today.
They're not?
No, it's Tuesday, dude. We did a live show last night.
Oh, man, it's fucking Tuesday.
Yeah, we missed the Monday. We missed our fucking window of opportunity. Did they used to be 2 days a week?
Suck my dick.
They're always Jacob knows.
It's only Monday.
You saw her yesterday?
Yeah. Well, this hasn't happened yet.
You'd be surprised.
Our live show. I showed her the thing we made for the live show.
What'd she say?
Where did you see her?
She loved the hat, the helmet.
She saw Dead Rat, which you'll learn. No, she...
It's fine.
God damn it. I always blow it. I blow it with so much stuff.
No, it's fine.
Did you come back here and she was here?
No, right before I left.
You go, hey, Deb, just going to go change the world.
But
I made this.
She's such a good sport. She loved it.
She's such a great sport.
She's the best.
Her husband's a lucky man.
Yeah.
Well, I mean.
I just wanted that reaction.
If you consider.
I couldn't ask for a better reaction. Did you? You got that clean, right?
Yeah, I think I did.
Thank you.
Is he a lucky man?
He just goes like this.
Yeah.
He did such wish upon a star.
Yeah.
But there was a little anger.
I don't know if he's fully lucky because she comes here and, I mean...
Sits nose to nose with Ben.
I've never seen two people before. If before a radio show, you saw me and Dan with Dan laying on the floor and I'm just like stretching his thighs out for him.
Can we start doing that?
Wouldn't you be like...
If Christine walked in and Jace is...
Are you getting ready to go play 48 on the hardwood?
Jace is laying on my knee. I go, hey, Christine, sorry. Real tight in the hip flexor.
Jay, do me a favor. Can you open me up before we get the show started? Oh, that's what Papa needed. That's what Papa needed.
Jay, can you... Jay, I really feel like my chest is ready to get stretched out. Can you...
So anyway, the point is, with Ben and Deb, it was all good fun. I mean, come on.
The entire fucking soul of this show are just idiot people who would be smoking cigarettes in a garage.
There's no threat, and if
you are threatening, please don't do that. Stop doing that, and that's an adult telling you that.
Especially because he called you all social media pussies.
Oh!
So, damn!
Oh, no. I mean, he was all in here like, yo, I didn't know just chicks listen to your show.
I wish they would catch me on the streets. Help fucking fugue them up.
Yeah, dude.
You're just fuguing the fire every time you send something.
You know what, Jacob? I'm going to say this, and this is the last we'll talk about it.
Why?
for a while, at least. I say you email him if you don't hear from him by the end of the week. Hey, okay. Hey, John, I want to run back. Just say, be like, hey, I just want those names.
He went, yeah, well. We say, on today, there was a thing, and we go, okay, well, send us the thing from today where someone threatened you. He's like, it was Facebook, but I mean, I'll try to.
No, that's not how it happened. He goes, you know, I got all these threats. I go, well, give me the Twitter handle. And then we'll reach out and do that. He goes, well, I got to go back for months to find that. And it's like, well, that's
First off,
that already debunks it because you said it's been happening consistently. So it should, even if it didn't happen today, it should be happening in the last week. And then I said, okay, cool. Well, didn't it happen today? And he goes, well, that was on Facebook. So, well, and it's like, all right, cool. Then we get a full name. Now we can just go a full name. Now we can publicly shame that person.
Now we can find out more
on the radio show.
We can find out who they're related to.
Oh, I'm going to go after their mom. You go after Fugues? I turn full heel.
But I mean, when he was walking out, we were like, yeah, dude, the joke is that like you really like Dan, you don't like me. He's like, I thought I was very kind to you when you came in. We were welcoming of you, and you're just kind of like, he's going so far the other direction. I'm sympathetic to the situation. I'm like, ah, yeah, dude, we don't want you to get like fucking trashed on social media. We're not looking for that, really. But it's like, when he goes, and then he goes like, wasn't I good to you? Didn't I give you the best years of my life?
But I think
we're going through a divorce.
I think what's interesting, yeah, I was there when you were sad, and I lifted you up, and now look at this.
Oh, he told me he liked my comedy. It made me feel so. I'm like, okay, man. We don't have a problem with you for real. You're making it weird.
But I think there is like this thing where for the longest time, the people that were considered to not have senses of humor were always conservative, buttoned up people who are like, oh, why would you ever joke about that? And that really was the thing. And it's like, that's why when you said the libtard thing, you're like, what? We talk about the most liberal shit sometimes. We talk about conservative. That's just, to me, that's like, that's how skewed we're starting to get, where now even the far left can't take a joke. Like, I'm watching one of our friends that just put out a special. They're getting, like, a bunch of, like, hate shit, and you're like, but they represent you, like.
I told them that was great. Only people who hate shit write anything. You can only gauge how loved you are.
Oh, yeah, I was there.
By timesing by 10 that amount of people who loved it, who do not get inspired to go write a letter about it.
Yeah. Yeah, but I'm saying, like,
I've never wrote a letter of positivity to anything in my life.
But my point's more like getting a joke. Like, it's a joke. We're joking around. We don't have a problem
with
you.
Well, look, I'm saying, do they leave their fucking trash around the table a little bit? Sure, they do.
Well, all jokes have a nugget of truth, Jay.
Of course. My thing is, though, again, I just, like, I hate explaining comedy, especially to a comedian, but I mean, he's like, I mean, do we really leave trash around that much? Like, yeah, sometimes, but dude, it's not even like, if I were him, I'd put like the trash can on the desk.
So basically, that's the best way.
I don't know how else to describe it.
The best way to describe it to our listeners is that it's a wife fight. We're in a wife fight. Our wife is mad at us. And they're like, do I really do that? Do I make you? I heard you talking to your friends. Am I really that hard on you? And you're like,
saying that
no, Stacy, no. You just, sometimes I want to go watch football at their house, but like, I know Sundays are supposed to be our days. It's just like, sometimes I need my time.
It's just a nighttime game this week, and it's just my friends are all there. I don't get to hang with the guys that much. And
but I thought it was, I thought I'd give you your time.
But that's what he brought too much real, and he's like, I thought I was very welcoming to you guys. Like,
you were!
It's like, dude, fine. Yeah, but it's like, welcoming and what?
Like, what happened to the good old days when you had a problem with someone, you just hired someone to murder him, like Diana Diabolablio?
But welcoming us in what capacity? Like,
yeah.
Is he like the Chancellor of SiriusXM? What does
Welcome
that mean?
Welcome to the studios. Well, I think
this studio was used by 14 shows.
Yeah. Well, whatever, man. We'll have Jacob reach out. We'll get the names.
If I had to say who this studio belongs to, it's SiriusXM. It's one.
Yeah.
And SiriusXM Insight, because it is the three banners that fly over our window to make sure no one sees when we
we'll get it
lick whipped cream off Jacob's dick.
Yeah.
Or whatever we have planned. But, yeah, so I guess long story short, yeah, someone's listening to us.
Also, Christine bailed on the Beta Rock playlist for the barbecue, which we covered on Monday, so I'm just bringing this up again, because I'm passive-aggressive, Dan!
Someone in the camp's listening to us.
Open up the barriers.
Give it, listen, let us know it's
Show
you.
Show us a sign.
I just go, let us know it's you by just, like, opening it like a foot.
Yeah, just... When he tells you to do it again, just leave it a little more ajar.
Give us some sort of a sign.
Yeah, give us a sign. We just want to know who you are. You're on our side, obviously.
We're okay with you.
Obvi.
Clearly, you understand radio.
Unless you're a mole. In which case, we will smoke you out and break your goddamn neck.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Let me find out it's Christine.
Oh, dude. How great would that be if you go...
She's been working for the Sang the whole time?
Oh, what if she was a Sang?
Fugle Stang.
On her dad's side.
Oh, man, if I were him, I would buy a Mustang tomorrow.
Oh, the Fugle Stang? How does he not?
I mean, how does he not have a fucking red
Mustang?
Oh, my God, with that beautiful hair, he'd be crushing so much ass
convertible?
With
a convertible Fugelstang?
Instead, I got to watch him tuck his wallet and pants into his socks so he can ride a city bike. This guy should be riding around in the Fugelstang.
Oh, dude, let's get money.
Get roadhead.
Oh, hell yeah. Getting sucked off in front of Sirius building?
Yeah. Instead, he's going home to a wife that irons his pants and he tucks into his sock to ride a city bike home. That's what's happening instead.
You want to ride in the Stang?
But hey. Hey, traitor. You know that. You already know that already. So open that screen about a foot. Give us a shot. Give us a shot to turn it all around. Maybe he'll love what he sees in there. Wait, is it being hidden? Is Mike Vecchione there?
Dude, if Mike Vecchione's in here, I'll tell you right now, I got to look for a new roommate.
I have a feeling Mike Vecchione's in there. Is that Mike Vecchione?
Oh, dude.
That's wrong if it is. He didn't tell you guys?
No, but I get it.